Give us, in a nutshell, the main findings of this survey. I was just going through the notes and I saw that you speak to something, I think, around 160 CEOs around the world.
Yes, Godfrey, thank you for the opportunity and good evening, viewers. KPMG globally interviewed 161 CEOs of the major global construction companies.
Sure.
In South Africa, we interviewed 9 companies, which gave us a good amount of interviews to be able to look at what's happening within the industry.
Sure. What did you find?
Some of the findings that we found is that the power and energy sector globally is by far the biggest attraction in terms of revenue growth.
Sure.
So everywhere around the world, we're seeing that that is the sector that companies believe is going to be the most attractive in generating future revenue.
Is that the same here in South Africa as well?
It's even more so in South Africa.
What's the percentage here?
In South Africa, it was 78% of respondents believe that that is the sector. Interestingly, though, in South Africa, mining was even higher. 89% believe that the growth in the mining sector would be higher than the global standard, which was about 4 or 5 down the line.
Surely that's surprising, particularly given the whole debate around nationalization, given the whole debate around increasing costs here in South Africa. We cite higher transport costs, we cite higher power costs, we cite higher labor costs.
Yes, it is. It was surprising. And so we asked the questions when I met with the CEOs, and I said, you know, why is this coming out as the area with the greatest push for revenue? Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, it's not for South Africa. Fortunately, from an Africa point of view,
sure,
it's Africa. Companies are moving north of South Africa because that's where the environment for growth and investment is more conducive than perhaps the South African environment.
Right.
Hopefully after yesterday when the minister announced and made some clarity in terms of the government's policy around nationalization, we will see things improving in South Africa, which means that our companies can come home to a certain extent and build projects here, employ local people instead of having to look north for growth opportunities.
So the higher percentage that you cite from the survey is actually CEOs who believe mining will be the key in Africa rather than restricted strictly to South Africa.
At the moment, they're seeing that as the big opportunity in Africa.
Sure.
Commodity prices, the way they are, the way they're booming, is creating that opportunity for big investments in other parts of Africa.
Yeah, okay. And the next sector after that that you found companies interested in is engineering and construction, I think. Did I get that right? Yes, that's where roads, bridges, which are tied to residential, and that stands at 24% globally.
That is correct. Now, that's quite a bit behind the power and energy. And that debate comes down from the big infrastructure needs of the world.
Right.
It's not just a South African or an African issue.
Sure.
That infrastructure is lagging. If you look across all 3 regions that we surveyed, you found that the lack of infrastructure was a major hindrance to growth and moving forward.
Yeah, I suppose that's not a surprise, particularly given that we know that the state of infrastructure in Africa itself is in a parlous state, and therefore the opportunity is even much greater than it is in perhaps your developed markets.
100% correct. I mean, we saw the impact of the Eskom problems in early 2008. And the impact that that's actually had on our economy and the growth. And there's still businesses that are being restricted from how much power they can use. Mm. Now, that's just an example of the infrastructure that needs to be provided in order for business to be successful and to grow.
Mm. Unsurprisingly, one of the biggest numbers that came out of the survey is the issue of uncertainty around the global economic environment, particularly given what we've just been discussing before we began the show, the whole issue around Greece, the whole issue around the Eurozone crisis, the whole issue around the health of the US economy, and whether China or not is going to have a hard landing or a soft landing.
Yes, I think it was 71% of people said that that was their biggest concern in terms of moving forward, was the economic uncertainty. Mm. Even in the Asia-Pacific region, where things are not very bad, it was 51% of people were saying, that is a concern. I'm worried about the uncertainty.
Right.
Now, for an area that's growing as much as they are, for more than half of the respondents to be worried about that,
yeah,
it just shows you how the world has become one global network. And what happens in Greece will taint what happens in Europe. And what happens in Europe will impact the whole rest of the world.
Yeah. So the question then becomes, so how does a company manage risk in this environment? It becomes a big concern, isn't it? Particularly given the long lead times on construction projects.
Well, that to me is one of the biggest findings coming out of the survey, that we believe that risk management in the industry is getting better and better over the years. But some of the results out of the survey showed that there are still major problems or lack of risk management in some of these big projects.
Yeah.
And as the projects become more complex, as companies become more global, the amount of risk that they take is perhaps unknown. And one of the findings was that in significantly underperforming projects, the company never identified the cause of the risk at the bidding stage. So they went into a project expecting it to be this size and to face these certain risks. When it failed and their margin was eroded significantly, 54% of those companies never even worked out what the risk was at the bidding stage. And now that's frightening, especially as things become more complex. And as you say, these big infrastructure projects, which are not really happening at the moment, other than we have Kusile and Medupi. But other than that, globally, there's not a lot of big construction projects on the go.
Yeah, as I guess that remains a big concern. Interestingly, one of the other findings was that, you know, in terms of issues that bar public-private sector partnerships, the survey found that the CEOs also blame themselves for the lack of progress on that front.
Yes, and interestingly, the South African respondents, when it comes to working with government, didn't actually see that the private sector has a big role to play in moving forward these big infrastructure projects.
And how can that be? Because we know that's where the money resides and also the expertise.
Well, the challenge we have in South Africa and many parts of the world is that private-public partnerships take too long to get going. There's too much cost involved with setting them up. And there's not enough working together with government rather than fighting against each other. So we need to get a trust situation where it's a work together, where it's a win-win for both. Because governments around the world, it's not only here in South Africa and Africa where there's a shortage of money and funds. The Americans cited that government deficits as one of the biggest barriers to infrastructure investment, because governments around the world don't have any money.
Absolutely, so they're borrowing and they're borrowing as good as us into this trouble.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So the big projects are all being delayed because of the uncertainty. Where is the future money going to come from?
Kevin, we have to leave it there. Thanks very much indeed. And I just wanted to cite one of the issues that you find around the issue that we've been discussing around the lack of progress on public-private sector partnerships. Your report cites policies, leadership, and investment by the public sector as one of the key concerns. But I suppose that's a conversation for another day. Thanks, Gavin.
Thank you very much.